pleasure to invite our next speaker from Italy, Davide Astiaso Garcia, who is the Secretary of the Italian Wind Energy Association, ANEF. Italy is a country which has a lot of experience, practical experience with wind power. You have many wind farms installed, but still you're kind of in a deadlock because obviously many wind farms are at the moment in the permission, in a queue waiting for permission, and there is not much progress. So we're looking forward to hearing from you the experience from an Italian perspective and what you see as the main challenges and barriers. Davide.
Yes, Stefan, thank you very much for inviting me. Yes, it's exactly as you said. In Italy, we are now living a challenging situation because we have to achieve some very important targets, but we have some practicalities that are locking down our new installation actually in the last years. So I'll try to briefly in around 10 minutes to present the framework of our situation here, and maybe I have here. Okay, I think. Yes, we are the National Wind Energy Association from Italy that includes more or less around 100 companies working in the wind energy sectors, mainly in the Italian business, but we are cooperating also with the other national ones, mainly at European level, but not only, and also with the other institutions coming from our countries in order to help to foster the decarbonization of the Italian energy sector. So this picture, I think, is quite clear to have an overall framework of about what happened in Italy in the last decades and what should happen in the next one. As you can see, we have more than 20 years ago, the first installation of wind farms in Italy until 2003, more or less. And then we have a constant growth for around 10 years or around, yes, 10 years, where also the Italian companies developed a huge expertise and know-how that is now useful not only for our country, but also for other foreigners' countries in around Europe. So we reached more or less 1,000 megawatt of wind power installed per year from 2008 until 2012. And then in the last 8 or 9 years, we have a sector impasse due to many factors, actually, not only a single one, but the important thing is that looking at our National Energy and Climate Plan objectives that are in the right part of the picture, you can see that we should change the speed of new installation. If we continued as it happened in the last years, we will not reach these targets. Of course, we have now also the recovery fund that most probably these objectives will be increased in terms of electrification of consumption, but also in terms of new installations coming from wind and also from photovoltaic. So at least we should reach these targets. So we need to change something to achieve these goals coming from the Italian government according with the European Parliament. So the current situation is we have around 10, 11 gigawatt of wind power already installed that correspond mainly to the production of 19 terawatt hours per year. Of course, this contribution is helping to halt the climate crisis in terms of avoided CO2 emissions and barrels of petrol, and of course the benefits are also in terms of direct and indirect employees. We have around 16,000 persons current employed. The targets I presented in my previous slides are more or less to double the onshore wind power installed, reaching at least 20 gigawatt for a production of around 41 terawatt hour per hour per year, and also the number of employees, which increased significantly, reaching according with an estimation that ANEV analyzed in the last years, we can reach almost 67,000 units. So, and we also have to underline that most of these employees will be in the central and southern part of Italy, that is the region which a huge problem of employees in our country. So the benefits will be double. Additionally, we have now in the National Energy and Climate Plan, we have around, we have 900 megawatts of wind power coming from offshore wind, but we have seen that according with the project that are under development right now, we could reach easily more than 5 gigawatt of wind power coming from our seas. We have a very important and huge new projects in Sardinia and Sicily, but also in the Adriatic Sea, mainly using the floating platform that are opening new perspectives for the Mediterranean seas due to the bathymetry project we had with the bottom fixed ones. So let's come to the authorizations scenario, that is one of the key problems we have now, one of the key barriers, that is a non-economic barriers, of course, because in terms of an economic cost, we do not have many problems. We reach almost the grid parity. So the difference is not so much, but the problem is really related with the authorization procedures that actually, as you can see in this graph, we had a very strong decrease in the number of megawatt authorized in the last decades, starting from the 2005 gigawatt authorized in the 3 years from 2012 until 2004. We reached the half of them in the next 3 years from 2015 to 2017. And then in the last 3 years, 2018-2020, we had only 500 megawatt, more or less, of wind farms authorized. We reached only 100 megawatts in 2020. And of course, this 100 megawatt that has been authorized in 2020 came from authorization procedures started mainly in 2014, in 2015, more than 5 years ago. So we had a 76% of decrease, and most of these problems are related with the problems of superintendences, as we will see in the next slide. Despite this, we have seen that the wind farms got the number of the auction we had in the last years. We covered one third of the multi-technology auction. We covered more than one third. We had the multi-technology auctions with the photovoltaic. According with the targets, photovoltaic should cover two thirds and wind one third. But we have seen that the wind covered more than expected. So this is a good starting point, but without changing the trend that you can see in this graph, we cannot ensure these numbers for the next years. And of course, we do not only have to keep these numbers, but we have to almost double this number in terms of installations per year. So let's see the main cause of the slowdown. Of course, the first one is the slow instance of authorization. It's not possible that we need around or more than 5 years for getting an authorization. So we need to speed up this process, also for having a positive or a negative answer, of course, but we cannot proceed in this way. We have excessive subjectivities in the environmental impact assessment procedures, also from region to another region, inconsistency between regional plans and national regulation and national targets. We have the constant denials from the superintendencies. As example, as you can see, we had 0% of authorization on over 9 gigawatt of requests submitted from in the last 4 years, from 2017 to now. So no one of them has been authorized. This is impossible. So we are working so close with the Italian Parliament. I had a speech yesterday with the senator, but also with the Italian government or with the local institutions, starting from the ministries, the new Ministry of the Ecological Transition. We asked for some solution that I will show you in my last slide, also for speed up also the controversies we had in relation with the superintendent's denials. So we need to make to bring these controversies at the national level in terms of the government authorization. And then last but not least, we had also some criticalities with the TSO regarding the authorization of the connection of the national transmission grid that are now held by the wind farm operators. We had with our president a very interesting meeting with the heads of Terna, that is the Italian TSO, and we find some very interesting solution for solving these problems, because they have now a very challenging work for authorizing all the requests they received. They told us that they received many more than 100 gigawatt of authorizations coming from wind and PV. So we have many new wind farms that are ready to be installed, are ready to get the authorization, but without this simplification, of course, the problem will halt the new installation. So we asked for a quick resolution at the Prime Minister's office. We had the first very good step with the institutions of the Interministerial Committee on Ecological Transition, the so-called CITE in Italy, with the new Draghi government. And as regards the fund, as I said, we asked, of course, to foster the new single technology auction from here to 2030. But we have seen that the economic cost related with the new auction is very, very small compared with the numbers of the recovering fund and the numbers of available funds coming from the Next Generation EU. We asked to invest funds in the research, especially in nanotechnologies and the plant of end of life. That is quite a challenging point. And lastly, we also are working so much for the promotion of the PPA power purchase agreement to really have the possibility to make PPA also in our country, because now actually it's not possible to make real PPA. And we estimated that the cost for having a specific guarantee fund for helping also the consumer and the producers is around 150 million euros in the next decade. So quite small sum. I think I very quick presented what are the situation in Italy, and of course if you have some questions, I'm listen to try to ask. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, Davide, for this, actually quite alarming message that you present us from Italy. Italy, which has also targets, climate neutrality targets, and one wonders, and it's, I think it's not unique, of course, maybe it's worse in Italy than in some other countries, but I think we have this challenge in general in many countries that there are more and more problems with the permission processes. So one wonders how governments want to achieve their climate neutrality targets if no more wind farms are allowed anymore. Could you just briefly explain, do other technologies also face problems at all? Solar PV or bioenergy, or probably there's also some small hydro potential. Just briefly refer to that, or is it really specific only for wind energy?
We have the two big problems for the two main technologies, because the targets in Italy will be reached by two technologies from here at 2030, wind and PV. Yes, we are also investing in the new ones, but the contribution will be smaller in terms of electric renewables, of course. Wind has this big problem with the superintendencies, with the Ministry of Cultural Heritage, that, as I said, is halting, is denying the authorization. And photovoltaic, from their side, they have problems with the agricultural areas. They are trying to find some solution, because now, without the installation also in agricultural areas, we have seen that it's not possible to reach the targets, considering only the installation in the buildings, in the coverage. So we have two technologies and two big problems for both of them. I think photovoltaic is solving maybe quicker than us, but let's see what happens.
Yes, well, thank you so much. And let me just mention, at this point of time, I think there was an important decision taken in Germany by the German Federal Constitutional Court, which said that the climate law is insufficient, that from the constitution in Germany, at least, there is a right can be derived for climate change mitigation, which is an individual right, which I think will, at least for Germany, kind of change a bit how different aspects have to be valued and assessed. I hope that will also have an impact on other countries, because obviously climate change has to be weighed in a higher way than other values. Like, of course, we don't want to give up nature conservation, but the relation must be obviously a bit different when we hear this from Italy. Now, again, thank you, Davide.